I'm Milan and you are locked into The Link Up, here to give you a weekly dose of everything music, entertainment and culture. Today I'm joined by grime veteran and boy better knows Frisco. How are you?
Bap, bap.
I like that.
It's good. I'm good, man. What's happening?
I'm good. So before we get into anything, earlier this week we went to LeoStayTrill's debut headline show and we captured the behind the scenes. Let's take a quick look.
So what do you think is the biggest misconception right now? And like,
a big misconception is that like I can't actually rap. And I didn't think that was a misconception until it's like I'm meeting people and they say, oh wow, I didn't know you could actually rap, like. So it's like, yeah, I can rap, innit? But it's just that I have to prove that. So, you know, time will go by and people will understand. They might not get it now, but they'll get it later. So it's like, yeah.
You might as well prove it now. Quick.
Oh, how are you gonna put me on?
Oh, so you can't rap? Oh.
It's been your boy LeoStayTrill. It's been my debut headline show. I love all of you lot. See you next time.
So we've got a lot to talk about today, but firstly, I want to take it back to 2020, where more specifically on Thuggish Ruggish, you said, to tell the truth, when I got my first kid, I was a kid myself, 16 with big dreams, and it's cool, I got to grow with him. So fast forward to 2024, the people are saying that you are the best father-son duo on the scene. What are your thoughts about that?
More than who's better than who, I think it's just a sick thing that artists now are stepping out with their sons, doing what they both, you know, set out to do in the first place. Like that, you're living, you're getting to live your dream twice. You're getting to see it through your own offspring. You get what I'm saying? It's a special thing. So more than like, who's the better father and son combination, I just think it's sick that this is even a conversation. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and,
of course.
And the focus point should be the fact that this is happening, like more than who's better than who. Do you get what I'm saying?
Of course.
But I just think that we are the coldest anyway. But do you get what I'm saying? But I don't think that's the most important part in this whole little thing, you get me?
And I mean, as a parent, you always want to support your child's dreams, but at what point did you realise that your son wanted to get into the music industry?
For a little while still, but like, I didn't know how serious he was, because he's always been around, like, you know, Boy Better Know and stuff we've been doing from when he was little. He's been coming to shows, he's been on main stage when we were doing Wireless, and he's seen a lot, basically, do you get what I'm saying? So I had to just see that he was actually serious about this, because everyone can say that they want to do music or they want to, you know, when they see the ups and they see the all the pros that you get with being an artist, it's easy to say that, yeah, I want to do that. Mm-hmm. But the other stuff that you don't see, are you prepared to do that? Do you get what I'm saying? And once he showed me that he is, it was a go from there, really.
Was there a specific moment where you felt like, okay, you are lyrically blessed just like me?
Yeah, definitely. At first, it took, like, he had to hone his craft properly, you get what I'm saying? When he first started, the potential was always there, but he wasn't ready, you get what I'm saying? And he's proved that he's ready now. So he sets a high standard for himself in terms of when it comes to like lyrics and putting these words together, you get what I'm saying? The cadences and the little metaphors that he drops, you get what I'm saying? And the sickest part is, you can hear, like, he doesn't sound like me, basically. Mm-hmm. His style is not the same as my style. He might take little bits and pieces, little things here and there. You hear him say, you can associate with me. But for the most part, he's got his own thing going on, you get what I'm saying?
So you both kicked off the year with a back-to-back on Radio 1 Extra with Sir Spyro. But let's take a look at the behind bars that dropped a couple of months ago.
Still getting paid in cash off bud, no cap. Really turned one into two, hot one throwing it back. Letting it crash, can't lie, I'm loving it too. Ever since bad one, we got the bad ones, all of them coming in twos. Like go ask math RCs, they'll show you the proof. I ain't got nothing in the whip, but feds are behind and I still feel a little piece nervous. Yeah, my boss, what the fuck do I look like me trying to beef with little man workers? Bet if I rise and clap it, your whole head back on, end up the furthest, killed bare MCs and I'm still here. Yeah, that's how you get away with murders.
So our hot topic of the week is grime back? It's got a lot of people talking, but what are your opinions on it?
Grime's never went nowhere. I don't think it's ever gone anywhere for it to be back. Is there like more conversation and more spotlight on grime at the moment? Yeah, definitely. Yeah. But we've been here before. We've been here a few times now since grime's started. This is nothing new. And this is just testament that grime is actually one of the mainstays, one of the main genres coming out of the UK and has been and will be going forward, no matter what new comes out. Do you get what I'm saying?
I mean, I was at Skepta's Puma launch event a couple of weeks ago and I saw the legendary set from you and the rest of BBK and some other grime legends. But there's been some tweets flying around on X, one from Chris the Capo. I'll read it out for you so you get some context. Controversial take, but I'm getting bored of these types of sets. They're glorified PAs. I'm hearing the same bars over the same cycle of beats. It's repetitive. Unless it's a set where I'm hearing new bars or the MCs sound enthusiastic, forget it. I'm not here for karaoke sets.
Okay.
What's your take on that?
That's what he thinks. I don't get what I'm saying.
Yeah. Like,
grime sets are about vibe. Like if you really check the essence of grime sets and going back to pirate radio, because these sets are coming from pirate radio. We're emulating what used to happen on pirate radio. So that's what everyone's seeing right now. The essence of that has always been hand to hand lyrics, man passing the mic, vibes, reloads.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? People want to hear you say your lyrics that they know. They want to hear you say your main reload lyrics. Yeah, they want to hear you say some new lyrics as well, but they definitely want to hear the main lyrics. Like when you go to a show and you see your artists that you love, yeah, you love that they got new music, but you definitely want to hear some of those classics that got you listening to them in the first place. You get what I'm saying? It's no different with a set. Like, that's probably someone that ain't really a fan of the music.
Fair. I mean, off the back of all of these tweets, Chip did tweet, best thing everyone does is leave grime alone with your opinions. Leave our pioneers alone. Have respect. You never catch grime people putting down other genres, but people feel so freely to speak on the ting. Bruh, allow it. Before you wake up some real killer MCs.
You get what I'm saying? He's not lying though, man.
Yeah.
He's not lying, man. He's not lying at all, man. But that's how it goes, man. The internet's just a platform for people to chat shit, man. You know what I'm saying? It just gives everyone a pass to feel like their opinion's even warranted.
Fair.
Your opinion's not even valued, wanted or warranted. So
yeah,
it even gives a shit what you think.
But I mean, at the start of the year, although, you know, many people's opinions don't matter. I mean, there was a lot of music enthusiasts saying that grime would come back into action. It needs to come back into the scene. 2025 might be the year that it does. Do you think that right now, with the state of the way that the music industry is, do we need to kind of bring back something from history to kind of revive it again?
Doesn't need reviving. It doesn't need bringing back. Doesn't need any of that. The only thing, personally, and this is just from my knowledge, and I could be wrong because I don't know everything and I don't know all the artists. I don't know who's new and who's the newest guy. Like, but to my knowledge, I don't know a big number of like youngers, like youths, like young. Do you get what I'm saying? Like early, like, you know, from like maybe 18, 19 through to 24. I don't know a big number of artists that age that are actively doing grime.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? There might be a few here and there, but I'm just saying like that influx. You know, like when you when you hear like a new sound and you see a crew from over here, from South, and then there's a crew from East, and then there's another crew from West London, and they're all, and it's kind of bubbling.
Yeah.
Like, I don't see that.
So what's been the biggest disconnect between younger artists and grime?
I don't think it's a disconnect. I think it's more of, like I said, there's phases and there's cycles. And at the time when the new batch of young artists are coming through, the cycle might have been drill. Mm-hmm. The cycle might have been something else, mm-hmm. Afrobeat or...
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it doesn't mean that it's a disconnect. It just means that they missed that cycle. When they're coming up now, it's this is what's popular. This is what's going on. They're not going to really look to... They'll know, they might know about it. Their older brother might have listened to it. So they know certain artists. And obviously there's... Like I said, the artists that are still doing it, they're still relevant. They're still in people's faces. So you will see little things here and there. But if you're not actually following it, if you're not following anything, you're not going to be well informed on it. Do you get what I'm saying?
Speaking on the scene as a whole, Skepta did tweet, the UK music scene is sad. Smallest, most segregated, label run, crabs in a barrel scene of all scenes.
He's not lying.
Do you agree? Do you always agree?
Yeah, if we're talking about like, if we go into that side, like I said, you got to have a thick skin to be doing this. That side, there's the part that could break, like it could break you, because not break you, but it could be the thing to make you say, oh, fuck this. I'm not,
I
got off the road to get away from some of this F3, you get what I'm saying? I never come to be legit to have to be dealing with certain disrespect, mm-hmm. you get what I'm saying? And if you never dealt with no disrespect, then you're certainly not going to deal with it now with people that, do you get what I'm saying? So, that, you see, and it's a sticky one as well, because if you're an artist that's dependent on a certain type of regime, mm-hmm. or a certain type of system, label, whatever, you got to play a type of game. You got to play some type of game.
Do you feel like label politics kill the game?
It can have a big negative impact, definitely. I wouldn't say kill the game, but I would say...
Creatively it impacts.
Yeah. Big F3 still.
Mm.
Yeah.
You are a very lucky man because we're introducing a new little segment into the show.
Go on, tell me about it.
Milan's Mega Quiz. So, are you ready? We've got two different segments.
Yeah.
So, right. What was the first UK garage track to hit number one in the UK charts?
The first UK garage track to hit number one in the UK charts. Good Times?
No. Sweet Like Chocolate by Shanks and Bigfoot.
Sweet Like Chocolate. Mm-hmm. I knew there was one that's something like that. Yeah.
Next one. What year did Kiss FM transition from being a pirate radio station to a legal radio station?
I'm not going to get none of these questions right, you know. 97?
No, it was 1990.
Okay.
Right, third question. Which UK male rapper currently holds the record for the most UK number one singles?
These questions are... Who wrote these questions?
It's a mega quiz. It's supposed to be hard.
All right. I don't know, man. Nines?
No. Tiny Temper.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Tiny was getting a bag of number ones at a stage, innit?
Exactly.
Yeah, for real.
Right, so segment number two.
Ask me some proper questions
this,
now,
this
man.
Segment is for you. It's called Boy Better Know. You're going to be quizzed about some questions on your BBK members.
Anything that you lot are going to know, I must know, so.
There you go. This is tailored to you. Tailored to you. Right.
Go on.
What London borough was JME born in?
Haringey. Hackney. I thought you said grew up in, you said born in, all right, cool. Mm-hmm.
What month and year was Jammer's Merkle Man officially released?
I don't know. Yeah, probably 2000 and...
5.
Yeah, and then a month.
Month. I don't know. January, July?
No.
February? December.
December. Yeah, okay. Right. Okay. How many UK top 10 albums does Skepta have?
How many UK top 10 albums?
Mm-hmm.
3?
Yeah. I mean, so on this round, you got 2.5 out of 3.
2.5. What one? What did I get wrong? Jammers.
You didn't get the month right.
The month right.
You got the year right, but you didn't get the month right. I got a bonus question for you, though.
Okay.
Right. You walk into a rave. You look around.
Yeah.
How many man is too many man?
Oh my word! I think that's an easy one, man. Everyone knows when there's too much man in the place. When you look around and it's just bare peaks. And hoods, and sunglasses, and not enough hair, and dresses, and open toes. You get what I'm saying? I'm seeing bare Air Force. Yeah, we all know those type of ones there. You get what I'm saying? Too many, man.
Well, thank you for joining me today. It's been a lovely chat. You look great, by the way.
Thank you.
And he smells amazing. You smell really
good. She tried to tell me, yeah, because she's trying it now, but she tried to say that my fragrance smells feminine. I can't believe it. And then said, oh yeah, but it smells nice though.
It's good. So up next, we've got Kamzo joining us with Keeping Up with Kamzo. But first, let's catch up with M24 at his studio session.
How's that one sounding? Or should I do it again? No, leave that. One more time.
We're just cooking up, man, something different again. You know the vibes, bro, literally, man. Just trying to hit them with a different sound now, you know what I'm saying? They know I'm the goat on drill, argue with your mother, but yeah. People say Joe's dead, but it's not. It's just the people that are at the forefront of these things right now. Not to downcredit no one's thing, but do you know what I'm saying? I don't feel like it's being represented. My work rate's not even where I even want it to be because I'm still not treating this thing like a job, like an opportunity. That's what I need to start doing more. Looking at this like, yo, this is my bread and butter. Because you see where it is? When I started, I was just doing music just because there was a studio in the area. Do you know what I mean? Like, it was there, it was accessible. I love music, it's within me. So, man, just hopped on the music thing. And it just happened to be going on, you get it, bro, and happened to be like paying off for me. So I feel like now is like looking at it more like a job, bro. This is like, man, this is like, yeah, it's what I need to work towards, you get it.
What's stopping you from working for that?
Nothing's stopping me, nothing's stopping me, bro. Yeah. It's me stopping me because of this, these thoughts. And it's normal, but we all go through it where we got to fight with our own demons, innit? We got to learn how to have control. And I don't think there's an age on that, bro. It's just about experience, you get it, bro. By 30, I do want to know what I want, and I do want to have certain things where I can say, you know what? Yeah, this is it. You know what I'm saying? At 30, and then through my 30s, like, then I can start living a little more as well, because I ain't got time to live right now.
How's the fitness journey going, bro?
Yeah. Hey, you know, every time I see you, you do this to me, bro. You know it is? I was doing gym for a good period of time, but you see gym is like gym school. Gym is like a thing. It reminds me of school because I've got to wake up at a certain time. I've got to go to gym. I've got to do this routine and I've got to come home and then I've got to study. And the studying part is me having to eat 6 times a day, every 2 hours, me having to drink the mass. Don't get me wrong. It's a good lifestyle and I'm trying to get into it like it is. Man's still, you know what I'm saying? Man's still living the fast life, bro. So it's just, gym, I need to incorporate it. I need more serious people around me that are doing the gym thing that can just put me in that. Because once I'm in that mood, I'm in that mood. But then life happens, you get, and then I forget. But fitness, like you said to me earlier, bro, man's, what did you say? Man's priorities,
yeah, remember
is on the wrong thing.
Yeah.
Man's, but like, we're prioritizing things that we don't own. You know, when you said it to me, I looked at you and I was like, huh? And then you was like, man's body is the only thing that man actually owns. So and man's not prioritizing it.
Everything you're taking from us, cars, everything.
No, it's true, bro. It's so true.
It's
It's so true, fam.
So how do you deal with obviously the mental side of things? So what's your escape? Because obviously music's this,
the ganjas. For now.
Yeah.
Maybe when I'm older I'll do some therapy or do something else. But the thing that saves me when I'm stressed, I get in the studio, like one of these.
Amen. Amen.
Back to the session I go.
Now for my favourite part of the show, where we learn a little bit more about some trending topics with Kamzo.
The way you said that made me sound like some real news anchor. I love it.
Well,
I love
you are a bit.
Thank you. How are you?
You're teaching me something. I'm good.
Yeah,
how
I love your Christmas jumper. I'm good. You should have told me we're all wearing jumpers. I would have worn one as well. You left me out, man. I'm just wearing essentials.
It's kind of a jumper. It's not as woolly. And this isn't a Christmas jumper. It's a winter jumper because it's absolutely freezing outside. It is freezing.
Viewers, let us know in the comments. Is Milan wearing a Christmas jumper in November? Please do let us know. But this week is serious still. You're even involved a little bit.
Why?
Don't worry. Tranquilo. We'll get into all of that. So the first topic of the week is university fees are set to rise to $12,500 by 2025. So this is the third time university fees have essentially risen up over the last 15 years. I remember when my brother went to university in 2012, I believe. Yes, okay. It was 3,000 by that point. And then it went up, it tripled to 9,000.
Mm-hmm.
Then in 2017, whilst I was in uni, it went from 9,000 to 9,250. They added a little change on it.
That's what you started paying. Yeah.
Then now they're trying to say by 2025, it's gonna go up again by another 3,000. To 12,500. Is there a point?
So 12,500 is usually what international students pay to come and study here.
Okay.
Right? So what will they be paying? Like 15 grand?
That's even crazy.
Will they be adding another three grand to that? That's insane. That is crazy.
So you had a child now, and that's what the rates were. Are they going uni? Like, would you encourage them to go? Like,
I'd still encourage them to go because I think it's good for them to have a degree, although degrees don't hold as much weight as they used to. But at the same time, I mean, you can pay it off over time. I know it's a lot, but you can pay it off over time. And I swear after 50 years, if you don't pay it, they kind of go anyway.
When I think about uni, like even in regards to the roles that I've done, I have not used my degree. I'm happy I've done it.
Yeah.
I'm happy I've had to hold my scroll and take a picture of my family.
Mm.
But to think I even paid $9,250 is insane. So secondly, Dr. Umar has been trending this week, but let's cut to a clip and hear what he had to say.
My Birmingham Kings, I need y'all to stop bunny hopping. Too much cottage cheese, too much skim milk, too much unflavored yogurt. Stop the bunny hop. You hear me? Black queens forever, snow bunnies never.
So this is what I was talking about, how it involves you this week.
Oh, okay.
A little bit. We'll get it. I'll break it. There's a little story.
I don't know where this is heading.
Don't worry, we'll take it there. We'll take it there. So Dr. Umar has come out encouraging men in the UK to stay dating their race as he does. You being mixed race, of course, you know, what do you think based on what he said regarding like black men in the UK should only stay dating their race?
I mean, I don't have much of an opinion on that.
You have all the opinions. Stop.
No,
you have,
I
you
don't.
Have, you can say it all.
But everyone's
you're that
experience,
person.
Everyone's experience is different. So yes, okay. I have a white mother and a black father, oh, right?
Didn't know that.
Interracial.
Interracial.
But like, what do you think?
No, like,
are you gonna say it's true?
No. Of course,
if
how can
so,
I say
get
that?
Out.
Of course, he, as a black activist, of course he's going to say that. But however, this is where it gets funny because a TikToker, I believe his name is Aaron Huntsman. Yeah, that's his name. He stated that. He said us, and that's why it's a bit upsetting because he's saying that me, everybody, Rashid, every single person that's black.
Yeah.
He said that. We won't be listening to you, Dr. Umar, because we are dating these white ladies because of the financial security they offer us. He said us, double down on the us twice. So he's saying that we can't
That's
date black
crazy.
Ladies, they're too expensive. Aaron Huntsman, please, man. I know, I get it, but let's do better, man. Let's stay as men, man. But one of the major topics of the week is Vybz Kartel that announced he is set to headline Wireless of 2025. But let's cut to a clip to hear what the King of Dancehall had to say himself.
Break down what go on for Wireless Festival. Wireless Festival is like one of the biggest UK festivals.
It is one of the biggest festivals. And I'll be there in, I think, next year, July. Contract signer, everything.
Fully confirmed.
Fully confirmed. So make sure on a day there, next year, Wireless, England.
Like, I didn't know that they were bringing out the lineup so early.
Maybe he's excited. This is his first international performance that he's announced.
Let's stop a little bit. He even doubled down further to say who he's going to be headlining with.
Yeah, I reckon
a man
that
said
was actually
Lil Wayne
as well.
And Drake. How greedy.
He defo was, you know, do you know what? It was confidential probably, but he was like, when I announce it, I need to show people that I'm still a big dog in this scene. No, like, I need to show people don't play with me. Like, yes, I've come out of jail.
Do you know how much the internet would have broke if, like, wireless dropped that? Like, imagine the promo they would have done. They're probably just scratching their heads like, damn. Yeah. They saved a lot of money though, because the promo they probably would have spent to do, it's not going to happen no more, of course, but... Bro, that's mad. But I was going to ask you, that lineup, so Vybz Kartel, Lil Wayne, Drake, that sounds like the best lineup you've had in a while.
That's a good lineup.
I think I'm there.
I haven't been to Wireless for like 2 years. And the reason why is I just feel like it's very same-ish. There's always kind of like similar artists. They've always got like the people who are currently at the forefront of the scene. And it's not very exciting for me. Bring back the OGs. Bring back like Drake. Bring back Lil Wayne. Bring back Nicki Minaj even. I feel like if they had like an amazing... thing, everyone of different ages as well, because I think it's a very young thing at the moment.
That's what I was gonna say next. So
it's caters to the younger audience.
My question now is predominantly, like you said, it's mainly kids that are there.
Yeah.
So how's it gonna be kids and all the adults that have been waiting to see Vybz? Remember, some people went when Vybz Kartel went Joe, like I was probably like 13, 14. Like I'm now a big man.
Yeah.
So like, you know, can you imagine how the mixture of ages are going to be there? You've got kids that have got mud up their knees and people that are probably going to be wearing heels. Like, it's going to be mad. And the last thing I want to talk about as well is, can he actually do it? Like, does he look fit? Because we heard about when he was performing in Jamaica like a couple of weeks ago and he fainted on stage. Like, of course, Wireless is far away, like, in regards to where we are now. But he doesn't look fit enough to actually be headlining Wireless. I'll be real, like people are tweeting, like someone tweeted, oh, put this guy in the room and saw how he's held first. And I hear it. So let us know in the comments, do you not feel like Vybz Kartel should be headlining Wireless? So see, then of course, give your opinions on everything we covered today. But that's been the Seas Trending Topics, Milan.
Well, once again, thank you for joining us and shedding some
light on some news.
You literally are very own news.
I'm the UK's best news anchor ever. See me on Sky News.
And that is a wrap. We shall see you next week.